Mogli bismo polako da nastavimo. Pred nama je prezentacija naše gošće, gospođe Sare, koja nam dolazi iz Nacionalne agencije Italije. Italija veliki broj godina koristi ovaj program i bit će nam svakako značajno da čuvamo kakva su bila iskustva, kakvi su bili početci škola iz Italije, izazovi i na kraju na koji način su svi ovi projekti mobilnosti i mogućnosti koje pružaju prethodne generacije programa Europske unije i sada i Erasmus Plus bile korisne i iskorišćene za unapređenje obrazovanja u Italiji. Sara, izvolite.
Dobar dan, buongiorno. Thank you very much. I'm really very happy to be here. And I thank you the Tempus Foundation and Maria personally for this invitation. I really feel very honored to be with you today. I just have this feeling that something new is starting, and I'm very happy to be present in this moment in which also the school sector in the Republic of Serbia will be part of Erasmus Plus family. So I will try to give you some advice and some encouragement to really be part of this program, and I really hope that you will be partners of many of Italian projects. This is a picture, and just to say hello, welcome. These are some colleagues, and it was during a celebration of a European festival in Florence. Something about me. I am Sara Pagliai. I'm the head of the Italian National Agency INDIRE. In Italy, the program is run by three different national agencies, three different organizations. My national agency is in charge of higher education, school education, and adult education, while there are other two national agencies, one only for VET, and one only for youth sector. So we are the biggest one. We have higher education, school, and adult education. Then in my agency, we are running also e-twinning and EPAL platform, and then we host the Euridice unit, which Euridice is the network which is in charge of information about all system of education in Europe. So as you can see, this is what is in our national agency, the budget we run, and as you see, the majority of the budget go to higher education, but also school is quite well represented, while adult education, unfortunately, is like the Cinderella of the program. Anyway, this is our figures. Just to show you, these are the funded project only for the mobility of staff for in the school sector. And as you can see, we had an increased number of not only of not mainly of project funds, but of the funding mobility within the project. And only in 2016, so last call, we managed to fund 2,000 in-service training for Italian teachers. So it's a good number, but nonetheless, it is not so so huge as we would like to be, because we managed to fund only the 10% of the application form. So Italy is a country with a lot of participation, a lot of cooperation activities, and we don't have sometimes enough money to satisfy everybody. Why to apply for a key action one learning mobility for staff? Mainly because the you have a possibility of cooperating, and as we already speak about this moment, the most important the focus is the European Development Plan. So in this document you have to state why you are applying, which are your needs. So before applying, you have to do an analysis of your needs. What is your school need? Why to go for European money? What is the added value to apply for a training abroad? And then you also have the opportunity to choose for three different activities. You can do a training course, so participate in a structured training course, or you can do job shadowing. That means that you have the possibility to go and in another school and see how things are going on, for example, in a school in Italy, because peer learning is some of the priorities of the European Commission and of this program. Or you can also have the possibility of do a period of teaching assignment. That means a real teaching in a school abroad. Here you will see some of the reason why to apply and which are the expectation from this kind of activities. And then I will show you that these are not just words, because after so many years of European cooperation and the European project, we also, as national agency, did periodically some studies of how this kind of project impact on Italian school, on the system of education in our country. And we see that, and we will see then that all these things that you can see in this slide are the result of a research. In fact, the mobility of the staff is not only let's say a very nice individual experience abroad. Is not simply a possibility to know another country or to have a nice time in a different school. It is really have an impact at professional level as individual, because it is really stated that after a period, after this kind of mobility, the competencies of teachers improved, and consequently the competencies of the pupils. And most of the teachers said that they really increased their motivation and satisfaction in their daily work, so they broader their understanding and practice of teaching. So one of the priority in the school sector for key A1 is that it is important, the relevance of the project is that this project should improve the quality of teaching. And I can say that it is really like this. And the experience show that those who had experience that did some European experience through European cooperation, really they have a different mind, they have a different teaching approach. And then there is also an impact at institutional level in the school, and then I will show you also in the system of education of the country. I really believe that in the bottom-up approach, and after so many years, something that has been experimented in a European project has taken on board systematically in the than in the system of education, at least in my country, in Italy. Here are other figures I go through because it's a strategic partnership. Ah, it's back. Okay. Sorry. This is one of the many studies we did periodically, and last year we wanted to do a research, a study on the first year of mobility in Erasmus Plus program for the school sector, but also for adult education and higher education. And we wanted to see how the program works and which impact and which are the outcomes of key one activities in our school. So we studied all the reports of the school and also the individual report of those who do mobility, and we went through 607 reports, and then we also did a more deep and quality analysis with 12 schools, and we asked them to participate in two focus groups, where we had a discussion with teachers and headmasters, and we analyzed strong and weak point of these key activities one. The result, as the result, as I was telling before, are mainly on competencies of the teachers, but also then competencies of the learners, of the pupils. The majority of the Italian teachers says that they increase their competencies in foreign language, but also in ICT. They learned from other countries a different approach, different methods, and this is very important, especially in the job shadowing experience. Because you really see the in practice how your colleagues is working, and then the main impact it's on the individual and in the professional level, but we will see that it's also in the school level. That is why it is important, the European Development Plan, because it is not only the experience of the single person, but is the impact, the experience then that can be measured at institution level, at systemic level. And here, again, in green, we ask many questions, and the green and the blue answer is I agree, I fully agree with this. And you can see we ask if the experience improve their role in the schools, they improve the offers more career opportunities, and for the great majorities this happen. And again, the satisfaction in the daily work, the improvement of ICT. Another important impact was the cooperation with the civil society, with the local community, because sometimes a school, after a European project, they want to show the outcomes to the local community. So also this improvement of the cooperation with the civil society, cooperation with the partner institution, of course. So this experience improved the cooperation between school and then many other practical abilities and activities as a teacher, again, especially if you go for a job shadowing. And here, the impact on the Italian school. First of all, the great majority says that they increase the cooperation with the others, and they improve the capacity of projecting in a European dimension. So, because sometimes schools are very close, they are a close community, at least I'm speaking about my country. They do they have to organize the lessons timetable, and this European project really open the door and change completely the way of doing lessons in schools, because then you have to adjust your plan with your partner, because for example in your country is a holiday, in the other country, just to do a very stupid example, but and then you really have a different organization, because you have to organize the mobility of the teachers. So it's really change the way of doing school, and this kind of project really improve the capacity of projecting, because you have to plan, you have to organize, you have to think. First of all, even at the very first step, as we said before, you have to think why I have to apply. Only to receive money, but for what? Which are the real needs of my staff? Why I have to go and train in another country? Is this other country will give me added value? So, you will see that planning the activities is very important, and planning all the phases of these activities, preparation. So before people move, before the mobility, also in the application form, you will have to state, you will have to write which kind of preparation you will give to these teachers who could attend the mobility. So preparation is important. Then the mobility itself, of course, is the main activity. Why you go for a mobility, to do what, to which kind of activity. And then never forget the follow-up and dissemination. Dissemination is very important, and it is one of the key point for us, because we always said that, for example, in our country, the success rate is only 10% of the application form. So if you are funded, if you receive the money, you will have to transfer your experience to other realities. This is the added value. So you have to show clearly how you will transfer your experience at institution level, but also on the level or the local community to other schools, that then you are a pioneer, and then you have to disseminate and attract others to do the same. So the dissemination phase is very important, and I really advise to pay attention to this part. Sometimes people think, okay, I describe the mobility, I describe why I'm going to that country or to the other, and that's it. No, you really have to think about the what is going after the mobility. And also after the your project is funded, it's very important this transferability of the experience. Then from this study, we learned that all the schools said that the school leaders, the headmasters, It's very important, as an important role in the project. We insist with Italian schools. We said that the headmaster is not simply the one, the legal representative who signed the contract or signed the application form, should be involved really in the active role of the headmasters, because it's the guarantee that it is the institution who participate, that the project is not of only of the single teacher, but it is of the school, and this is the important if we want a systemic approach. Then I was telling you that some innovation which was experimented in the very beginning of all the European cooperation has been then introduced in the normal and in the legislation of our school system in Italy. One of these is the CLIL method, that is content and language integrated approach, that means to teach a subject, to teach a subject in a foreign language, and for example, math in English or science in English, history in French, and you have this combination of the two things. And this is now in the legislation of the Italian school for upper secondary school in Italy for some subject. But it was used the first time by the school who participated in a European project. Why? Because they have to they were running a project, for example, on history, and they have a partner from Poland, from UK, from Portugal, and they did these normal activities in the school, but in collaboration, cooperation with other partners, so they use English. It seems, and so from this experience of the European cooperation, now, for example, CLIL is part of our system of education. The other one is the use of ICT. Now, we have a national law which is from enhancing the digital it's the digital agenda for schools, but of course those who first had to use ICT because they have to communicate with Spain or with France or whatever, they were the first school who used ICT. So you see, the European cooperation anticipate some of the innovation that are now part of the normal life of the school system. So here I show you the website. It's a screenshot of our website where you can find some good practice example of Italian school. Unfortunately, these are in Italian, but in most of the cases we link these with the dissemination platform of the European Commission. So you can go and see also in English if you are not familiar with Italian. And here, for example, we have a school of Messina, Sicily, the very south of Italy, and they went for 2 months in Holland, and then they observed a method for the they were mainly working with children with special needs. Then some of the method had been then introduced after this job shadowing in the school in Messina. And here, for example, it is another job shadowing, and it was a school that had problem of school failure. Of it is a secondary school, and with a high percentage of dropout. And they work in a project with Cyprus, again in a job shadowing, for increasing the motivation of the pupils, and they empowering their self-esteem. They were trying to really give more self-esteem, to encourage them to be more entrepreneur, and so limit the school failure, and on the other way to help them to find better possibility to be then occupied after the study. And again, another example I'm telling you, it's a school in Bologna. I take this example because they went for a training course, but then they used e-twinning for preparation of the mobilities, during the mobility, and then as a dissemination activities after the mobility, they started to do many other e-twinning projects. You can see the partner organization are many. And so as a dissemination activities from the outcomes of the mobility, they started e-twinning project to study more what they learned during the preparation. So I will say two words about e-twinning, because I think that e-twinning contribute very much to the quality of Key Action 1 Erasmus Plus. Don't imagine e-twinning different from Erasmus Plus. I always insist this also in my presentation in Italy. E-twinning is part of Erasmus Plus. It is an important tool, and when you are thinking about planning your Key A1, think about e-twinning as a good instrument, a good tool to implement your project for the preparation of the mobility, but also for the dissemination of your outcome. It's really, really important. E-twinning in Italy is very popular. This year we have 42,000 teachers who are registered, and we have more than 12,000 projects that are running. So it's a success stories, and I encourage always this synergy between Erasmus Plus and e-twinning. This slide show you very clearly what I'm speaking about. So use this, and also when you are describing, if I can give you an advice, when you are in the application form, I think it's important to say that you are using e-twinning as a tool for implementing the Key Action 1 activities. Before, there was a question about the catalog. There is no catalog, and as Maria already explained, because it can be a training course, a very good training course everywhere. But then you have also this tool, School Education Gateway, by the European Commission. It's another portal. And here you will find also some, could be that you find some good courses for school education. Also in e-twinning, sometimes there are training courses that are organized by European SchoolNet. Our NSS also does, with the help of expert, training course, conference, regional seminar, or mainly webinar on the most important issue at the moment for schools. Here are some are all our my contact, and my last message is that is this one. We next year 2017 we are celebrating the 30th anniversary of Erasmus. That means that in 1987, the first student of the university had the possibility to join the program. The Commission said that it is not only the celebration of the Erasmus as the university, but of all the sectors. So, in view of this celebration, during these days, my office is very busy to go back to stories of those also from schools that participate as a pioneer in the European program. We have people from 1995, that was the first program, Comenius or Lingua. And I can guarantee that in the beginning they were very few. They had lots of problems. They don't have great expertise in writing project application form and so on. But then what everybody says is that it is really worthwhile. Those who first participate never left. They are trying and trying because it's really an added value. And so this is a picture of Florence because my agency is located in Florence. You see the big E in the middle of Piazza Santa Maria Novella. It was a video, but I cannot show. It was a flash mob made by students of schools and the university. And so I leave you with this image, and I'm happy that this celebration will be also with you. I mean, you are now part of the family, and so welcome. And I am here also to say that we are very much open to this cooperation, Italy and Serbia. And if you need schools, Italian schools, especially good schools, I'm here also for contacts through the national agency. And even if this school year I cannot fund Italian to Serbia, but I'm sure that if it is a great cooperation and the numbers are so high, I mean, I'm sure that next school year will be mobility in the two ways. So I think it is important to participate and to start. Good luck to everybody, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sara, for a very nice presentation and for the encouragement. We know that it is very difficult in the beginning, but it is a comfort that it will not take 30 years, I hope, to get this group of people. We will do it, I hope, more quickly. But the numbers are encouraging, and the statistics and the data that you provided, and I'm sure that there will be many questions and interest. And the other thing that we discussed before was that Sara and the National Agency in Italy could also, in case you have a doubt, provide maybe some advice on the place where you could go to a training course, since not all the training courses, they're not listed anywhere, but you can go technically in school education to a university or an institute or to an NGO or to an enterprise in VET. So there are many possibilities. So if you have a doubt or if you need assistance, it is also possible to discuss.
Yeah, sorry, I forget. If you have some questions to me now, I'm open to questions.
Izvolite, gosti će odgovoriti na pitanja. Ako ima konkretnih pitanja ili dilema, znamo da često se, tek kad krenu projekti da se sprovode, susretemo s prvim pitanjem, ali ako imate eventualno neku bojazan ili dilemu ili niste sigurni, dobro iskoristiti. Svakako ove italijanska agencija ima godine iskustva u sprovođenju ovih projekata, tako da ako vas zanima možda sa aspekta saveta ili oko evropskog razvojnog plana, ako postoji eventualno neka dilema, verujem da gošće. Izvolite.
Spomenut je pojam digitalna agenda za škole. Me zanima da li ona predstavlja deo evropskog razvojnog plana.
Sorry, yeah, and it was, I couldn't hear the translation. Yes, it can be. I mean, when the, for example, the Italian schools describe the needs of applying for key action one activities, one reason can be also for the innovation in the digital device in teaching with the ICT. For example, the one of the last reform introduced in Italy what we call animatore digitale, that means teachers with the responsibility of innovating the teaching method through ICT. And some of these schools which have these animatori digitali had been funded by Erasmus in a specific training course or in job shadowing in countries in which this innovation for ICT was already much more developed than in Italy. I'm thinking about Nordic country like Finland or Sweden.
Ali takođe, ako mogu samo da dodam, nije uslova, Sara će mi ispraviti, da vi u svoje potrebe uvrstite ICT, odnosno IKT kompetencije. Znači, to može da bude i preduzetništvo, može biti potreba za nekom obukom iz oblasti inkluzivnog obrazovanja, ako ste upravo u vašu srednju školu upisali određeni broj dece koje su išla po IOP-u, po individualnom obrazovnom planu. Dakle, to od vas zavisi šta su vaše potrebe.
Yes, exactly. The European Development Plan starts, as I said, from an analysis of the needs. It is the first things you have to do is an analysis of what you need, what is your aim for applying, but you really have to start from this analysis. In some part of Italy, for example, the biggest problem is the school failure, is the dropout. And so they start from this figure and they will find the course or job shadowing in order to find some remedies or to innovate, for example, the way of teaching, the increasing motivation of the students and so on, to reduce the dropout. In the south of Italy, this is unfortunately one of the biggest problem Italian schools have.
Da li imate još pitanja za gošću ili eventualno komentara? Ako ne, predložila bih da napravimo pauzu za ručak do 14 časova ili eventualno da se koji minuti ranije vratimo. Da nastavimo sa radom, posle podne nas očekuju još tri vrste projekata za koje možete da konkurišete i naravno ako budete imali pitanja za našu gošću, gospođu Saru, koju se zaista zahvaljujem na vrlo dobroj prezentaciji, možete ta pitanja postaviti, ja verujem i za vreme ručka će Sara biti otvorena, a možemo odvojiti deo posle podnevne sesije ako bude bilo potrebno. Hvala najlepše.